If you look at the Sabil logo, we tried to depict this. For us as Christians, there is the way, and then the water flowing from the foot of the cross. So we're trying to capture those two perspectives, that we are on a journey. Maybe the cross here expresses the suffering, the pain, that it's not a picnic, that we are really working together, laboring with God, but on an issue which is very, very difficult. As one of the speakers earlier said, you can be critical about anything in the world and you can get by with it. If you stand for justice on the Palestinian conflict, then you're going to be put down and you're going to be attacked. So we are really on a journey, and we would like all of you to join us in this journey of peace and journey for justice and for reconciliation. So Sabil is a movement that started within Palestinian Christians. But it was a movement that started with the grassroots. We tried to maintain good relationship with the hierarchy of the churches. But most of our work has been done through the grassroots of the Palestinian Christian community. But from the very beginning, we recognized that if we want to be faithful to God in where God has placed us, we cannot just work with the Christians. Yes, we have a long agenda with the Christian community, but we also have a long agenda with our Muslim brothers and sisters. So Sabil works with the Muslim community, and we thank God that we have very good relationship with them. And we also recognize faithfulness to God means also working with Jewish peace groups, because they are also walking the way of peace and truth and justice. So we are thankful also for our partnership with Jeff Halper and similar organizations within the peace camp, in not only in Israel, but here in the United States and in Canada and in other places. And I want to say from the very beginning that Sabil promotes the two-state solution. Now we recognize that maybe in an ideal world, the one-state solution is the best. It's a small country. It'd be wonderful if we can live together as Jews, Muslims, and Christians. But realistically speaking, and actually, and I want to emphasize this, actually, for the sake of our Jewish brothers and sisters, we are working for the two-state solution. Because we know that Israel, in spite of all of its power, Israel feels very insecure. It's very interesting that the strongest people and the strongest country feels insecure, and the weakest people and the weakest country feel very secure. This is the dilemma. This is the contradiction of what we live by. Because we believe as Palestinians, we're very secure in our country. In spite of the conflict, we're secure, we're there. And yet we see the insecurity of people of power. And so for their sake, we say two states, they need to be secure. And we leave the future to the people of the land. If the time comes in 50 years or in 100 years, where they believe that, yes, it doesn't make sense to be two states, then maybe they can walk together and they can take the right decision then. But for us today, we are working for the security of the state of Israel. But that security cannot be achieved unless there is justice and security for the Palestinians. And this is the bottom line. And this is what we are working for.